sea un vuelo de la franquista que haga de salir del Jaime.
¿Un vuelo de asusta?
¿Viste que era?
Hello, good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Brigham Young University. We are very happy to be here. It's a pity that this beautiful music hall is empty, but we hope you will enjoy listening wherever you are. So my name is Michael Asaf. I'm a member of the RAM Trio, which was founded in 2004. This is Karen Lipker, our violinist, and Marina Shayevich, our pianist. Karen has studied at the Music Academy and Dance in Jerusalem with Haggai Shacham, and currently she's a member of the Camerata Orchestra in Jerusalem. Marina has also studied at the Jerusalem Academy of Music and Dance with Yitzhak Katz and Irina Berkovich, and also with Eitan Globerson and Ido Ariel, and finished her master's degree there in co-repetition and performance. And Marina is currently a faculty member at the Jerusalem Academy of Music and the Sadna Conservatory. I studied at the Jerusalem Music Academy with Shmuel Magen, completed my master's degree there, and then I went on studying in Germany, Karlsruhe, with Martin Ostertag. Our trio was founded in 2004. All of us were students at the time, and since then we have performed extensively throughout Israel in places like Targ Center, Mishkenot Shananim, Kfar Blum Festival, and of course the Mormon University. So today we will play for you three pieces, ordered chronologically. The first piece will be Rachmaninov's first piano trio, written in 1892. The second piece will be Turina, Joaquin Turina's second piano trio, written in 1933. And the third piece will be one movement of Piazzolla's piano trio called the Seasons. We will play the spring movement. So we will combine three pieces. The first is romantic with beautiful Russian themes. The second is impressionistic with Spanish flavors. And the third is one of the most well-known tango pieces with jazz flavors, which probably most of you have heard sometime in their life. So I'll tell a bit about each piece before we play it, and then we will play the piece, and then I'll say some words about second and third piece after we finish the first piece. So the first trio of Rachmaninov, who was born in 1873 and died 1943, the trio Elegique, was written when Rachmaninov was only 18 years old. It was performed 1 week after it was written with the composer at the piano. The trio is made of a single movement, unlike other typical piano trios, which are written in three or four movements. It is written in a sonata form, and where the elegy moves first from starts at the piano, then moves to the cello and the violin, and the tempo, as you will hear, the pace will increase throughout the piece. It starts slow, lento, then più mosso, più vivo, con anima, and then it goes back to a slow funeral march at the end of the piece. This trio exemplifies Rachmaninoff's ability to write for piano as well as strings, as well as his usage of rich spectrum of sounds, colors, and harmonies. Usually, an elegiac trio is written in someone's memory. This is the case with Rachmaninoff's second piano trio, which was written to commemorate Tchaikovsky's death. It was written in 1894. This trio, even though it is called elegiac, it was not written in memory of someone, but as a homage to Tchaikovsky's piano trio in A minor, which is also called elegiac trio, which was written to the memory of Anton Rubinstein, a famous pianist and composer. So both of these trios have a lot in common. First, the first thing is that both of them have a very long movement, which includes a funeral march at the end, and a theme which includes only four notes, as you will hear. It is made of four notes, and this theme goes as a thread between the instruments, as you will see, as you will hear. So, without further ado, we will play the Rachmaninoff First Piano Trio. Enjoy. Thank you for listening. You probably realized the slow funeral march at the end, very depressing music. Now we will go to hear something completely different. The second piano trio of Joaquín Turina, a Spanish composer born in 1882, died 1949. And it is known that Spain had a golden era in the Renaissance, but then there was a void in the classical and romantic periods, music-wise. But towards the end of the 19th century and beginning of the 20th century, the Spanish music has revived through composers such as Granados, De Falla, and Albéniz, which wrote magnificent pieces around 1900. Among them was young Joaquín Turina, who was, as I said, born in 1882, and then went to study in Paris with Vincent Dandy, a contemporary French composer. He was strongly influenced by Fauré, Debussy, and Ravel, who worked at the time in Paris. So Turina, to those of you who do not know him, he wrote many chamber music pieces, including piano trios, quartets, quintets, sextets, and also a very famous string quartet. Today we will play the second piano trio of Turina in B minor. This trio is really lively, sparkling, concise, with beautiful melodies and harmonies. It combines between the romantic tradition of piano trios with three or four movements and contemporary Spanish and French harmonies, colors, and sounds, which are mostly attributed to Debussy and De Falla. The trio includes Spanish motifs such as melodic intervals, special harmonies, and rhythmic patterns, which are mainly evident in the second movement, as you will hear. It is in a very special meter of 5/8. Even though Turina was strongly influenced by Debussy and Ravel, and this is clearly demonstrated in his music, especially in this piece, one should remember that these composers were fascinated by Andalusian sounds. So one can say that Turina can borrow back quite naturally and authentically these motifs, which is evident in this piece. The first movement of the trio is written in a sonata form with contrasting themes in minor and major, as you will hear, with beautiful impressionistic flavors. The second movement is based on a Spanish dance in 5/8 with a relaxed trio. The third movement is really majestic. The beginning is majestic, but it has very a lot of miniatures, a lot of miniature motifs, which are reminiscent of a large variety of Spanish motifs, as you will hear. In this movement, Turina uses a very special technique borrowed from the French school of a cyclic structure where he returns in this movement to all previous motifs that appeared in the first movement. So some of the motifs that you will hear in the first movement will reappear in the third movement. This movement has a vivid finale with increasing tempo and enchanting harmonies. So I strongly recommend to listen to this wonderful piece. And if you haven't heard it before, you will have a very pleasant surprise. So enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for listening. This was the Turina Piano Trio, second piano trio. Now we are arriving at our last piece, the dessert of this concert, the Primavera Spring movement of the Astor Piazzolla trio. Astor Piazzolla is an Argentinian composer. He was born 1921. Died 1992, so it sounds like contemporary music, but as you will hear, the tunes are very tonal, very easy to hear too. It's not modern music. Well, it's modern in a sense, but not, I mean, it's easy to listen. So it was written by Astor Piazzolla in 1965 to 1970. Originally, there were four pieces, four seasons, written for a quintet with bandoneon. Bandoneon is an instrument like accordion. It is similar, but it has a different sound. So originally, it was written as four different pieces, and it was assembled as a single trio or a single quintet afterwards. Piazzolla has developed the tango style and added new sounds going beyond the traditional tango, which was originally invented by immigrants that came from Europe to Argentina and Uruguay. So Piazzolla added to this traditional tango all sorts of complex harmonies and jazz-like rhythms which changed the tango. It is called tango nuovo. And the spring movement, as you will hear, it has a vibrant jazz-like tango rhythm with a slow intermediate lyric segment whose themes are closely related and combined towards the end. So without further ado, we will now play the spring movement by Piazzolla and enjoy.
לא, הפרסונית עובד בשיטה אחרת.